The next is love and belonging, friendship, family, sexual intimacy. Now here's the deal. There's many of us, we want this kind of stuff, but the reality is if I'm hungry and I'm sleepy, don't kiss me. Right? I mean, we talk about real talk here. If I just lost my job, I'm really not trying to hang out with you right now. Right?
But that's not who you've been calling me. You've been calling me.
you know, you've lost someone in your family. If your house has been broken into, let's just say your health, you find out that something is going on in your body. All of these things affect what we talked about in the beginning of your ability to just be. They affect your ability to just be. And so I want you to just think about this, and I'm not going to ask you where, but I want you to think about where you fall on this grid. Are you just barely making it with sleep, food, water, and breathing? Are you still trying to figure out your way as far as employment, maybe trying to get your home together, maybe you know, there's some resources that you're trying to get together, just a lack thereof? What about love and belonging? Maybe you, and here's the thing with friendships, if you want a friend, be a friend. If you want friends, be a friend. Remember we talked about, I am open to give. You can't always be open to receive and be like, okay, thank you, bye. You can't be a taker. So my first exercise, I want you to look in your bag. There's a mirror. I want you to open them up. Big lips, little lips, wide nose, tiny nose. Because here's the deal. When you look in the mirror, it's not me you see. And although this is my attempt and you're trying to pay attention and you're trying to look attentive, but what you're also doing is trying not to look in the mirror. And it's time for you to be able to look at you and see you for who you really are, and not for what they said you were, or what they said you weren't, or what they said you should be, or what they said you shouldn't be, or what they said you could be, or what they said you couldn't be, or what they said you ain't never gonna be. I don't know what you thought that was all about. Or who they said you're just like. I want you to see the fabulous, awesome, super juicy. Yes, super juicy. Woman in that mirror. So I want you to look at yourself again. And I want you to stay looking at you. Don't look at me. I want you to look at you. Absolutely. I want you to look at the beauty that God created. Not the flaws that you see. I want you to see the perfection in your imperfections. I want you to see that every nook and cranny that you see, God sees as beautiful. And somewhere, somebody or something told you that what you see is not enough. And I'm here to tell you that you are. So you can exhale and close the mirrors. That, whoo, thank Jesus, oh God, whoo. But I want you to, how many of you, and this is not a TMI question, but it is, and you'll understand why I asked this question in a minute, but how many of you actually look at yourselves in the mirror naked? No? Never? Not even when you get out of the shower? No? Yeah? You check it out? I mean, you just, yes?
Check it out.
And the reason I... And the reason I ask that question is because, and I'm just going to be transparent with you, when I had my son 3 years ago, almost 3 years ago, my body went through a transition. It might not look like it, but it did. And so I remember one day looking at the man, I've always just kind of got to the point where whether I like it or not, I look at it. And we talk about this with our girl, YNP girls. I asked, I said, do you know what your body looks like naked? Oh, this, no, I'm not looking at it. self-actualization. All of us want to be in the, you know, we want to be at the top of our game, and we want to just be at the top of our lives, and we just want to be just fantastic. It's just, we just want to be just awesome. Just, but you don't want to deal with the skeletons that's in your closet. You don't want to face you. And here's the deal, you can't face other people if you don't face you. You just can't.
I know.
You can ask a question. Yes.
The part, I was uncomfortable looking at myself in the mirror. But I was told growing up, get out of the mirror.
All that. And I said, well, no, that you think she's all that.